Well, I think the best day is when you do an experiment, maybe an experiment that is a little risky, that you know if it's going to work, that you hope it's going to work, and you go to the microscope and you look at this, and it worked just as you predicted, and you feel how your heart start beating because you know this is something good. And that only happened to me maybe 2 or 3 times so far in my life. My laboratory is interested in understanding how cells work, and in particular, we are very interested in lysosomes. This is an organelle inside of the cells, and it's basically the main degradative organelle. And it's not to be really important to degrade different materials. It could be cargo, nutrients, pathogens. So in my laboratory, we basically have 2 projects. We want to understand how lysosomes work in normal conditions, and we want to understand how they work under pathological conditions. Why, when lysosomes don't work properly, sometimes that led to human disease. In humans, there are like 70 different diseases that are caused by mutations in lysosomal proteins. Specifically, we work on mucolipidosis type 4. It's caused by mutations in mucolipin 1, that is a cation channel that localizes to the lysosome. And we are trying to understand what is the function of this protein and why, when this protein is mutated, lysosomes don't work properly, and that led to neurodegeneration, blindness, and many different problems. But the next step is going to be try to learn a little more about the physiological function of those proteins in vivo. So we are moving a little more toward animal models, and we are now doing different experiments, as I say, in mouse, but also in zebrafish. So for example, in zebrafish, we just generated a knockout for mucolipin 1. And I think this is going to be very useful because zebrafish have the advantage that you can follow the embryonic development because those animals are transparent and it's very easy to monitor, for example, the formation of the eye, the brain, the different blood vessels, just by looking at the animal.
Usually I start exploring the localization of proteins basically in the cells using microscopy technologies. But then we use other approaches like biochemistry, trying to understand interaction between proteins.
So right now I'm doing a tunnel staining for my zebrafish. Basically, I have a knockout line, a gene knockout line, and I want to characterize their phenotype. So I'm washing those fish, and later on I will stain the fish with fluorescence. So tunnel staining is specific for apoptosis detection.
You know, I think the thing that was really cool when I first joined here is I learned a lot very quickly. You know, a lot of things are very accessible, which allows you to answer questions a lot more quickly. So instead of having to wait for reagents to come in, or maybe you don't have an instrument you need, it's all there. So you can really start addressing things very quickly. And that surprised me, really, just how quickly I was able to do things and to learn a lot in a short amount of time.
But what we are learning, and I think it's important to keep that in mind, it can then be applicable to many different diseases. By understanding how mucolipin 1 is regulating fusion of lysosomes with autophagosomes, we found that autophagy's function is very important in lysosomal storage disorders, and now we are finding that many different diseases have very common characteristics to that. When you really know you have a beautiful story and it's something that makes sense but it's unexpected, it's unknown in the field, and then this energy that you get wanting to know more about what you found, I think this rush in adrenaline that you get when you get a very good result, I think that makes the days like very good days.